Today we're going to be taking a look at the Beelink ME Mini, a compact mini PC that's designed to be used as a small home NAS. It supports up to 6 NVMe drives and includes dual 2.5GB networking with link aggregation for fast file transfers, all in a compact and silent package. So let's take a closer look at it. Inside the box, you'll find the Beelink ME Mini at the top in a wrap that covers all of its sides. And in the compartment below, we've got an HDMI cable, a power cable, and a user manual. Like with most mini PCs, there's no Ethernet cable included, so you'll need to provide your own. The ME Mini is impressively compact. It's a 99mm square cube, with ventilation holes on the top, bottom, and two sides. This is the white version, and it's also available in grey and a turquoisey colour called Peacock Blue. On the front we've got a USB 3.2 Type-C port, a power indicator LED, a power button, a sleep indicator LED, and a second USB 3.2 port, but this one's Type-A. There's nothing on the two sides besides the ventilation holes, and around the back we've got the AC power input, a USB 2.0 port for a mouse or keyboard, which can be set up to be always powered on, then dual 2.5GB network ports and an HDMI port. Four screws on the bottom hold the cover in place. My only complaint with this arrangement is that the screws are initially covered with stick-on plugs, which is a bit strange or inconvenient on a device that's intended to be opened up to add drives to. With the cover removed, we can see the internal all-in-one heatsink, which is quite a clever design. The 6 NVMe drives are installed on either side of the heatsink, for a total capacity of up to 24TB. On this model we have a single 2TB drive pre-installed, but the remaining slots all have thermal pads ready to go, so it's super easy to install additional storage. They say that it only supports up to 4TB drives, which I assume is either due to thermal or power limitations. 8TB drives are usually double-sided, and the heatsink only makes contact with the front of each drive. This means that they're effectively installed backwards, or with the front of the drive facing inwards. These are all M.2 ports for 2280 size drives, and they're all PCIe Gen 3, although 5 have a single lane and 1 has 2 lanes. The 2-lane one is intended for the operating system. This will cap drive speed quite a bit, as Gen 3 drives need 4 lanes to achieve their rated speed, but they've done this because the N150 chip only has 9 lanes available in total, so you won't get the full speed out of these drives if you're using the ME Mini as a mini PC. But as a NAS, given that we've only got a maximum of dual 2.5GB networking, the single PCIe lane is enough to saturate the connection in any case. So it's a smart choice that probably won't have any real-world impact on the system for most of its intended use cases. Beelink have partnered up with Crucial, so this series is kitted out with Crucial P3 Plus drives. I'm going to add a second 2TB drive for testing, so we can see what speeds we get from the single lane ports. It's great to see that they've partnered with a reliable storage partner, and they aren't using generic unbranded drives in a device that's intended to be used for storage. On the back of the heatsink is a built-in 45W power supply, which means there isn't an external power adapter, and the ME Mini just takes a straight mains cable. This is also impressive given its compact size. The power adapter is rated for 12 volts and up to 3.75 amps. The heatsink it's screwed onto functions as the drive, power supply, and CPU cooler. A single fan, which they claim to be silent, provides cooling to the heatsink from the top. It blows down and out through the ventilation holes on the sides and at the bottom. There is quite a lot of metal to the heatsink, so we'll see how it performs later on in testing. With the heatsink removed, we can see that it has a nice machined contact face with the CPU. The ME Mini is powered by Intel's new N150 CPU. This is a 4-core CPU made up of only efficiency cores for a focus on overall power efficiency. It has a maximum clock frequency of 3.6 GHz and a 6W TDP. So it's quite similar to the older N100 CPU, but with a slightly higher maximum clock frequency. It has 12GB of LPDDR5 RAM running at 4800MHz, and 64GB of eMMC storage. Both are soldered down, so are not upgradable. We've already seen the dual 2.5GB Ethernet ports on the back. and in addition to this, it's got Wi-Fi 6 and Bluetooth 5.2. Out of the box, the ME Mini comes with Windows 11 installed, but since it's intended to be used as a NAS, I'm going to go ahead and install TrueNAS on it for testing. It's quite a flexible platform though, so you can easily get started with TrueNAS or Unraid as a NAS, or go with Kodi, Plex or Jellyfin as a media center, or even Proxmox for a home lab, although the 12 gigs of RAM might hold it back a little. I think it's a sensible choice for Beelink to leave the operating system open to the user, rather than trying to create their own. There are plenty of free or affordable NAS operating systems available, and Beelink are doing what they do best, sticking with the hardware design. You've probably also noticed that I've mentioned that it has an OS allocated NVMe drive, but also eMMC storage, so you've got some flexibility there too. If you're using a lightweight OS like Unraid, which predominantly runs in RAM, then you can install this on the eMMC chip and keep your drives free for storage. Alternately, you can install Windows or Linux on an NVMe drive for better performance. With TrueNAS installed and running, we can see our system information, CPU and memory stats, drive pools and network connections. I've created two storage pools, one on each installed drive. I did this so we can separately test each port's speed and see if there's any difference in speed over the 2.5 gig network connection. First up on the two-lane drive, with an automated tester using a 1 gig file, we get writes of 260 megabytes per second and reads around 245 megabytes per second. A larger 16 gig file gets similar speeds and a large 64 gig file the same. I then switched over to the single lane drive and again got very similar speeds. For the 1 gig file, we get writes of 260 megabytes per second and reads of 245. Like with the two lane drive, we also get similar speeds for the 16 gig and 64 gig file. I then tried a real world test copying a large 46 gigabyte video file to and from the NAS. On the two-lane drive, it managed an average of around 280 megabytes per second writing to the NAS, and the same speed reading from the NAS. And this was also very similar on the single-lane drive, so through both sets of tests we get very consistent and reliable speeds, which are about what you'd expect from the 2.5 gig network connection. There's also no difference in speed between the two-lane and single-lane drive, which is also expected given that the network connection is the bottleneck, but it's good to see the results confirm this. Thermals are also great. You can barely hear the fan running, and even under a stress test for 15 minutes at 100% CPU load, the temperature didn't go above 55 degrees. The case also gets warm, but not hot. Speaking of the fan, there's very little noise coming from this little package. At idle it's silent, and under full load, it's also very close to silent. At full load, you can just hear the fan if you've got your ear within 20 centimeters of it, but any further away and it's inaudible. The ME Mini is also impressively power efficient. With the two drives installed, it uses just 8 watts at idle, around 12 watts under full write load, and a maximum of 15 watts when the CPU is fully loaded too, so it's not going to do any damage to your power bill. Pricing starts at $209 for the base setup with no SSDs installed, which I think is pretty good value for money. This steps up to $329 with a 2 TB drive, and $429 with 4 TB of storage. All other specs stay the same across the range. You're not really getting a discount on the price of the 2 TB drives, as the difference is roughly what you'd pay for 2 TB P3 Plus drives yourself. But the base $209 cost of the mini PC is really good value for its feature set. So who's the Beelink ME Mini for? It's a great option if you want an affordable, quiet and energy efficient NAS that provides OS flexibility. It's perfect for a home media server, to back up your files, or even to run a few light Docker containers. You can also start out with 1 or 2 SSDs and you've got room to add storage as you need it. It doesn't have hot swappable drive bays, a hardware RAID controller, 10 gig networking, or a PCIe slot, so it's really intended to be used as a lightweight and portable home NAS, not for demanding applications. But for $209, you really aren't going to find much better value. This is even cheaper than my own Pi NAS build that I put together last year, and it's a lot more powerful. Let me know what you think of the ME Mini in the comment section below, and if there's anything else you'd like to see me test on it. Thanks for watching, please remember to like this video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe for more tech and electronics projects, tutorials and reviews.